Hello students, in the lecture 1 we have studied about galvanometer, its types, principle and explanation of D'Arsonval galvanometer or PMMC galvanometer. On the principle of PMMC galvanometer, here we are solving a numerical problem. So we can solve it. It is a very simple numerical. If you have read this, that is, read the question. A moving coil instrument has a coil 1.5 cm wide and 1.2 cm long. In between this reading, you can write down the given value here. What is given? First one is, what is given? That is, breadth of the coil B equals to, or D. We have chosen the value D in the last lecture for the width, that is 1.5 cm. And length of the coil is 1.2 cm. Right? We can convert it into meter, that is 0.15 meter, and here is 0.12 meter. Now, read the next. The flux density in the air gap is 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 3 Weber per meter square. That is, flux density is given, which is represented by B, that is 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 3 Weber per meter square. The spring constant is 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton meter per centimeter, per radians. That is, spring constant is represented by K, that is 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton meter per radians. Now what is asking? Determine the number of turns required to produce. Number of turns N is asking. What is this value? To produce an angular deflection of 90 degree, that is theta is given 90 degree. When current of 5 milliampere is flowing through the coil, that is, I is also given 5 milliampere. As we know that here is constant controlling torque, controlling constant is given, or a spring constant is given. So we know that controlling torque equals to K into theta, and theta is also given here is 90 degree. We can put the value 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 7 into 90. 90 degree, it is in degree. We can convert it into radians. That is pi by 2. Here, this value is coming 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton meter. Now, we also, we have given B, I, L, D. L and D combinedly we can calculate area or deflecting torque directly can be calculated N, B, I, L into D. That is, all values are given, only number of turns is unknown. N, we can put all the value 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 3. Into value of current is 5 milliampere, that is 10 to the power minus 3 into L 0.12 into distance 0.15. So all this value is coming 16.2 into 10 to the power minus 10 N Newton meter. N is your unknown value, number of turns. Now, we can, as we know that for final steady state deflection, controlling torque is equals to deflecting torque, TD. We can put the value TC equals to 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 7 equals to TD, that is N into 16.2 into 10 to the power minus 10 is the, therefore, N is equals to 16.2 into 10 to the power minus 10 upon 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 7 is equals to 136 Newton. Sorry, I have written the wrong value, that is N is equals to 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 7 upon 16.2 into 10 to the power minus 10, that is 136. This is the answer, that is number of turns is equals to 136. N equals to 136. So we can see that this type of numerical is very simple, all is numerical, is formula based. Now here we are discussing the next topic, that is dynamic behavior of galvanometer, or we can say that theory of galvanometer. There are four types of constant in galvanometer is included, that is all known as intrinsic galvanometer, intrinsic constants. All these four constants combinedly known as intrinsic constant. Here we are dealing one by one. First one is your displacement constant. Firstly, come to the diagram. Here we are seeing that there is a coil, which I have already discussed in the construction, and the source is applied, current is flowing across the coil, and there are four types of torque developing in the galvanometer. First one is your the deflecting torque, which deflects the needle, and second is your inertial torque, which is also known as damping torque. Damping torque is defined as the damping is produced by the friction due to motion of the coil in the air. That is, we know that coil is moving. Due to the friction of the coil with the core or in the air, a damping torque is produced. That is given by B equals to, damping torque TD is equals to d theta upon dt. First, next is your inertial torque. Inertial torque is a retarding torque which is produced owing to inertia of the moving system. As we know that there is a mass of the system or coil, so here it is also moving. So due to inertia, there produce a inertial torque, which is given by J d2 theta upon dt square. And we also know that for steady state deflection, there should be a controlling torque, which is produced by the spring or the suspension. So these four torques can be defined by the four constants, which is known, first is your known as displacement constant, as we have already discussed, that is G is known as displacement constant and given by B and A. Second is your constant of inertia, that is J, and inertial torque is given by J d2 theta upon dt square. Third one is your damping constant, that is d d theta upon dt, and fourth one is your the controlling or restoring constant, that is Tc equals to k theta, and these four combinedly known as intrinsic constants. Now we can define the behavior of the galvanometer by writing the equations of motion. So equation of motion is defined by when current is given, when current is flowing through the eye, the instrument eye, or through the instrument, then equation of motion is given by total controlling torque, inertial torque plus deflection torque, damping torque is equals to deflection torque. That is what I am saying, inertial constant or inertial torque plus damping torque plus constant controlling torque is equals to deflection torque. We can put all the values, and here we have derived the equation of motion, that is J d 2 theta upon dt square plus d d theta upon dt plus k theta equals to gi. We can solve these equations by and find the value of theta. So as we know that differential equation can be solved by in two parts, that is CF plus PI, complementary function plus particular integral, as you already studied how should it can be find, and CF is find by, we can write this value equate to 0, that is LHS is equals to 0, and put all the value to the M, differential value to the M, and then find this M value M1 M2 which comes to minus D plus minus root under D square minus 4JK upon 2J. Now CF complementary function theta is given by A e to the power m1t plus B e to the power m2t. For particular integral at a steady state condition or final steady state condition, we know that controlling torque is equals to deflecting torque, and all torque should be equals to 0, that J t to theta upon inertial torque, and damping torque should be 0. So from here we can see that theta equals to gi plus k. So the complete solution is given by theta f equals to, complete solution is theta f equals to a e to the power m1t plus b e to the power m2t plus gi upon c. From this equation we can derive three conditions of the galvanometer behavior. First one, we can find that first condition case 1, that is D square is greater than 4J. That is 4JK. From here we can see that, or we can say that root under D square minus 4JK is less than D value, that is this value, this. So root under d square minus 4jk is less than d, that is when the instrument damping is large, or it is called over damped oscillation. That is over damped oscillation or over damped condition. So we can say that motion of the galvanometer is non-oscillatory and deflection rises gradually from 0 and then becomes a steady state position. That is, we can say that it is a steady state conditions, and deflection rises gradually, and at a point it comes to the steady state, that is theta, and here is time. It reaches to the final steady state position under this condition, that is D square is greater than 4JK. Case 2, that is when D square is less than 4JK, when that value becomes less than 4JK, that is this is the condition when the instrument is under damped, that is it is under damped condition. undamped conditions, and its graphical representation is given by theta, and it is theta, and it is gradually rises and then come to the steady state position, and its damping is light. Now, and it is called underdamped conditions. And case third is your that is d square is equals to 4jk, that is critically damped condition. It is called critically damped condition. In this condition, the instrument is called dead beat. It is also called dead beat, and whose graphical representation is given by it is rises to the final state deflection and then continuously come to the constant value. So all these conditions is described for the behavior of the galvanometer. Thank you for watching.